Today we are going to examine the thyroid gland. Now I will show you the steps of examination of the thyroid gland. This is my patient. She is a 35-year lady having a swelling in the neck for last 2 years. And today we will examine her. We will go through the steps. First of all, I will greet the patient and ask for permission from the patient for examining her. Now I am doing it in Bangla. Assalamualaikum ma.
Waalaikumsalam.
I am a doctor. আমি আপনার গলার ফোলাটা একটু পরীক্ষা করতে চাই। আপনি কি রাজি আছেন? আপনার গলায় কোনো ব্যথা আছে?
না।
আমি আপনাকে কোনো ব্যথা দিব না। এবং আপনি যদি ব্যথা পান আমাকে জানাবেন, আমি পরীক্ষা করা বন্ধ রাখব। আমি কি আপনার মাথার কাপড়টা সরাতে পারি?
জি।
সো আই এম রিমুভিং দ্য হেড কভার। অ্যাজ ইউ ক্যান সি দ্য পেশেন্টস হেয়ারস আর নিটলি টাইড। So I don't need to do anything extra, but in case if the hairs are open, then you'll have to tie it. Now I'll start my examination. As you can see, there is a swelling in the neck. The examination of the neck will always start by sitting. So dear examiners, when you see a thyroid patient is there sitting in a chair and there is another chair empty waiting for you, don't hesitate to sit in it. It is important to examine the patient in sitting position because your eyes are at the level of the patient eyes. So while you ask question to the patient, just by looking into his her eyes you will get some clues regarding the eye signs. Now as you can see, there is a swelling in the neck and I am proceeding with my examination again in Bangla. Ma, apnar golar ei phulata koto din theke?
2 bochhor theke.
Apnar etar jonno kono oshubidha hoy? Byatha kore?
Ji na.
Acha, aste aste boro hocche na druto boro hoye jacche?
Aste aste boro hocche.
Acha, thik ache. Apni ki ekta dhok gilte paren? Acha, dhonnobad. আপনার বাড়ি কোথায় মা?
গোপালগঞ্জ।
আচ্ছা, ঠিক আছে। আপনি কি এই ফোলাটার জন্য কোনো ঔষধ খান?
জি না।
আচ্ছা, ঠিক আছে। আপনার শীত বা গরমকালে একদম শীত বা গরম অসহ্য বোধ হয়, এরকম কি কখনো হয়?
জি না।
আচ্ছা, ধন্যবাদ। অ্যাজ আই এম সিটিং ফেস টু ফেস উইথ দ্য পেশেন্ট, ফ্রম ফ্রন্ট সাইড আই উইল সি থ্রি থিংস। ফার্স্ট অফ অল, টেম্পারেচার। I will compare the temperature with the forehead of the patient. There is no raised temperature. Then I will see tenderness. I will just gently put my hand over the swelling and look at the facial expression of the patient. When you see tenderness anywhere in the body, don't forget to look at the face of the patient because the feelings of pain will be expressed in her facial expression, in her eyes. So when you see tenderness, you look at the face of the patient. Then you will see the position of the trachea. You put your index finger and the ring finger of right hand on the external end of the clavicles. Then your middle finger will locate the trachea. I will see whether the trachea is in central position by putting my hand on both sides of the groove between the sternocleidomastoid and the trachea. On both sides there is equal groove. So the trachea is in central position. So I have seen 3 T's from the center, from sitting in front: tenderness, temperature and trachea. Now I will stand up. And I will go to the back. But before going to the back, I have one thing to do from the side. That is to see the retrosternal extension of the thyroid gland. As because the patient is swallowing again and again, it is difficult for the patient to swallow without water. I will offer her some water. এই পানিটা মুখে নিবেন, কিন্তু আমি যখন বলবো তখন গিনবেন। Now look carefully here. I will put my hand at the neck, at the root of the neck, then ask the patient to swallow. When the patient swallows, the thyroid gland will move up. So if there is any extension of this swelling behind the manubrium, then it will come up and will be palpable in my finger. So this is the retrosternal extension of the thyroid gland. Now I'll go to the back of the patient. Most part of the thyroid examination will be done from back. First of all, I will have to see the surface and consistency of the thyroid gland. To see the surface, we will have to gently press on one side, then palpate the other side. Why we are pressing on this side? To make the other lobe more prominent. Now, what can the surface be? The surface can be smooth. The surface can be bosselated. If the surface is smooth, your diagnosis will be it's a diffuse goiter. If the surface is bosselated, then your diagnosis will be a multinodular goiter. Now, on the same way, we'll press gently on this side and palpate the other lobe. On this side, nothing is palpable. A normal thyroid gland may not be palpable. So, in my this patient, this lobe is not palpable. Left side is not palpable. There is a swelling in the right side. Now, surface examination is complete. Now, I want to see the consistency. What is the consistency of this gland? Consistency of a normal thyroid gland is soft. But in case of multinodular goiter, if the nodules are solid, consistency can be firm. And again, if there is cystic degeneration within the follicle, the consistency can be cystic. And if there is malignant transformation, the consistency can be hard. So, after seeing the surface and consistency, I will see the cervical lymph nodes. Now, many of us do a very common mistake. While examining the cervical gland, they make the patient head tilt. But as you can see, if you extend the neck, the platysma is taut. So you cannot palpate well anything that is deeper to the platysma. So you will have to flex the neck and make the platysma relax. Now you palpate the cervical lymph node. As you can see, I am fixing her head with my hand, and submental group, submandibular group, preauricular group, postauricular group, anterior cervical chain, posterior cervical chain, supraclavicular lymph nodes are usually seen by asking the patient to shrug. আপনি কি কাঁধ দুটাকে একটু এরকম করে উঁচু করতে পারেন? হ্যাঁ, এরকম. These are the supraclavicular lymph nodes. এবার নামাই দেন. We will end our examination by doing the occipital lymph nodes. So, the cervical lymph nodes are done. Now, we will do some special tests related to thyroid. One is Cocker sign and the other is Berry sign. Cocker sign is done to see whether the swelling is compressing the trachea. This, as you can see, is a moderate size swelling and not very big. but in case of large swelling, it can compress the trachea. Anyway, as a part of examination, I will do the Cocker sign here. I will gently press over the swelling and will ask the patient to take a deep breath. And in the meantime, I will come close to her to listen whether there is any noisy breathing, that is a stridor. Now I am doing it. Ma, apni mukta ha kore ekta lomba ashwas nen. Chhere den. There is no stridor. I will repeat the same on the other side. Abar nen boro kore shwas. Chhere den. So this is Cocker sign, which is negative in this case. Now what is Bayley's sign? In Bayley's sign, I want to see whether the carotid pulse is in the proper place. Now you'll have to know where the carotid pulse actually is. You locate the thyroid cartilage in the neck and then go laterally until you see the sternocleidomastoid muscle. As you reach the anterior border of the sternocleidomastoid muscle at the level of the thyroid cartilage, you can palpate the carotid pulse. It is in the proper position. And one mistake should never be done, that is, never palpate carotid pulse of both sides together. Now I will do the same on the opposite side. It is in place. So the Bayley's sign is done. Now what is left is, I want to see whether this gland is fixed with the underlying structure, that is the sternocleidomastoid muscles. How do we see this? We'll have to make the sternocleidomastoid muscle taut. There are two ways, and both are correct, to make the sternocleidomastoid muscle taut. Like, this is her sternocleidomastoid muscle. If you can see carefully, I place my hand on her right jaw and ask the patient to press with her jaw on my hand. Then the sternocleidomastoid muscle, you will see, become prominent. Chual diye amar hater upor chap den, matha ghuran. Ghuran, jore aro. See, the sternocleidomastoid is taut. Now I will see whether the gland is fixed with the muscle or not. It is not. In the same way, you will see the fixity of the gland with the sternocleidomastoid muscle on the opposite side. Ebar ei hater upor chap den. See, the sternocleidomastoid muscle is taut. And you see, there is not much of a gland palpable here, so there is nothing. So this is fixity of the gland with a sternocleidomastoid. Mentioned you before that this examination can be done in two ways and both are correct. This is one way. The other way is, if you want to save some time, you can put one hand below the chin of the patient and ask the patient to tilt the head. Matha nichu kora chesta kore ami badha dibo. See, both sternocleidomastoid muscle becomes taut at the same time. Then you can see together on both side. Okay, relax. So this is fixity of the tumor with the gland. Now we have completed the surface, the consistency, fixity of the gland, Cocker sign, Bayley's sign, and cervical lymph node. If you want to see eye sign, though it is not very important, final professional examination of surgery, because most of the patients when come to surgery are usually euthyroid, but when you are sitting, standing on the back, you can see one eye sign, which is Nabjigar sign. Ma, matha ta uchu koren. Apni chhader dike takaben. Takiyechen? When the patient looks at the roof and you are standing behind, what you are supposed to see is the eyebrows of the patients only, and not the eyeball. If the eyeballs are popping out and you can see it standing on the back, then the patient has exophthalmos. This is called Nabjigar sign. Now my job from back is almost done and I will again come forward and see three things in the hand. Let's come forward. From forward, what I want to do is I want to examine her hand. I will take her hand in my hand. Again, we will see three things from here. One is pulse. Ideally, you will have to see the pulse for a full 1 minute. But due to time constraint, I will show you just 10 seconds. But remember, during examination, you will see at least 30 seconds. Then you will move the palm of the hand and see how the condition of the palm is. If the patient is hyperthyroid, then the palm of the patient may be warm and moist. General people have moist hands, especially when they become nervous. But due to nervousness, when the hands become moist, it is usually cold. But in hyperthyroid, it is warm and moist. Then what will happen to the hypothyroid patient? Hypothyroid patient has less sweating. So the skin is dry and coarse. Now I have seen pulse and palm. Now one last thing to be seen. I will ask the patient to spread her arms and her fingers and I'll sit here to see if there is any fine tremor. This thing also you'll have to see at least for 30 seconds. Thank you. Now my examination is almost complete. Don't forget to cover the patient. Don't forget to thank the patient. Thank you, ma. And then you will turn to the examiner and you will tell that to complete my examination, I would like to see the sleeping pulse and auscult the chest of the patient. So this is all about thyroid examination. If you have any questions and queries, please comment on the comment box. Thank you.